Now, let's listen to Minister Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi.
कि जो मुद्दा राज्य का गवर्नर का होता है, गवर्नर से संबंधित होता है, उन मुद्दों पर स्थगन प्रस्ताव नहीं लाया जा सकता। और ये स्पीकर साहब या चेयरमैन साहब उसको तय करेंगे कि किन नियमों के तहत वो लेके आए हैं, क्योंकि ये बहुत स्पष्ट और बहुत एक सेटल्ड व्यवस्था है कि गवर्नर के रोल पर किसी भी तरह का या राज्यों में जो गतिविधियां हो रही हैं उस पर जो है वो किसी तरह की चर्चा नहीं होगी।
सर, मेरा आखिरी सवाल, होपफुल है सर कि वहाँ आपकी सरकार बची रहेगी आगे?
सरकार 5 साल चलनी चाहिए, चलेगी।
ओके, सो आर्ग्यूमेंट्स नाउ इन द सुप्रीम कोर्ट फ्लाइंग थिक एंड फास्ट। द सोलिसिटर जनरल हैज जस्ट हैंडेड ओवर अ लेटर रिटन बाय द गवर्नर सेक्रेटरी सेइंग दैट दीज आर द साइंड लेटर्स, these are the signatures of all the NCP and BJP MLAs. Now remember, whether those NCP MLAs actually consented to being with the BJP, that is the moot point, because these NCP MLAs are saying a letter was indeed signed by them, but they didn't know at that time that that is to support the BJP. That's the plea that they're making now. The governor, the letter that he's received has 54 NCP MLAs signature on them. Now that is interesting, because that's the letter that Ajit Pawar took to the governor. That letter has now been handed over. We will see soon when Kapil Sibal starts arguing along with Abhishek Singh with the other letter. 53 MLAs have signed that letter, which says that we're actually backing the Sena to be chief minister. So this argument will continue in this fashion.
Yes.
How long do you expect this to go on for, Sumit?
See, this will go on. Both the sides will give their own defenses. And let's not forget, what we have to see is that what documents are not being produced, what the court is going to take into consideration is what is the documents available before it. So let us not at this stage start presuming what it has seen and what direction it's going to take. But yes, it is going to take time, because the parties who could not appear earlier, like rightly said the Maharashtra government, will now be able to produce itself.
Rajiv Pandey of the BJP joins us this morning. Rajiv, welcome. At this moment, 53 MLAs of the NCP have signed this morning a letter saying that they have confidence in Sharad Pawar, that they're actually backing Sena to put out the chief minister, that the Sena, NCP and Congress are together, which possibly means that the previous letter that they signed, which NCP MLA said they didn't know what they'd signed it for, because they didn't know it was for the BJP, that letter may now be infructuous.
Rahul ji, the new letter which they have given it to Rajapal ji, where they're 53 signatures of the MLAs are there, that has no legal sanctity, because now governor has not invited NCP or Shiv Sena to come and show their strength to the honorable governor. Governor has already, after looking at the letters given by the BJP and Ajit Pawar ji of the 54 MLAs, have taken a decision, considered decision, and invited to form the government under the leadership of Devendra Fadnavis ji and Ajit Pawar ji as a deputy CM. So now this all drama going to Rajapal Bhavan and giving these letters has no meaning in the eyes of law. Today, what is pending before Honorable Supreme Court of India? Yesterday, Honorable Supreme Court of India has rejected their interim application, did not grant any interim orders in their favor, and asked whether the letter is given or not, whether the governor has taken a decision on the basis of those letters or not, whether those letters are forged or not. Now they are themselves admitting that we have signed this letter. So in my view, now the Honorable Supreme Court of India will have to decide whether it is justified to give a government 7 days to prove the majority or not. Whatever NCP, Congress and Shiv Sena have said yesterday in Supreme Court of India, everything has fallen flat, because the letter of Ajit Pawar ji is there, letter of the support is there.
In fact, that's the point that Ajit Pawar made in the Supreme Court. The Solicitor General is reading out the letter that was signed by Ajit Pawar on the 22nd of November, saying that all elected MLAs have unanimously elected me leader of the legislature party and have given the right to form the government to me, and I have then gone and supported the BJP. So it comes down possibly to a technical argument, saying I am the leader of this legislature party, you've elected me, you've given me the right to form the government, and I have gone and allied with the BJP. That's the point, Smriti Kopikar, that Ajit Pawar seems to be making in the Supreme Court this morning.
Absolutely. It began 48 hours, a little more than 48 hours back, as a tale of two Pawars. Today it's come down to being a tale of two letters. I, however, still believe that it's not just the letters or the head count or whatever. It's what these NCP MLAs, the 53 who claim to be with Mr. Sharad Pawar this morning and have tried to tell the governor of Maharashtra that, what will they do on the floor of the House, both during the trust vote and during the speaker's election? It's quite possible that they have today declared support for Mr. Sharad Pawar, but will succumb to pressures, lures, inducements and all of that and vote the other way when the time comes, which is why this whole bazaar and market that's going on, horse trading, corruption, buying, inducements, this is serious. I don't think we should use euphemisms like headhunter and Operation Lotus and all that. Operation Lotus, actually, if you look at it, has a fairly pristine meaning. So why are we denigrating the Lotus or the word headhunter? Let's say it as it is. This is a bazaar. This is a market. There are inducements being offered. There are MLAs who are being sought out. You know, so it's quite possible that 53 who have this morning declared support for Mr. Sharad Pawar, some of them might easily go the other way when the time comes.
No, but the point is, and Javed will bear this out, just a couple of people switching doesn't help. Even those who are on the fence or want to support Ajit Pawar will do so if they feel that he's the winning horse. It's the winner's bandwagon effect. If they think he's winning, they'll pitch their lot with him. If they think he's losing, even if they're on the edge or even in his camp, they may stay with Sharad Pawar.
Yeah, because nobody wants to sacrifice their membership.
Sure.
They are just, you know, most of them are just starting their terms. There's nothing to gain in being with the losing side. And therefore, everything will depend on the numbers. The reverse trend that you're seeing now, which is a lot of those who had deserted NCP going back, is a result of that. Because they appear to have realized that the numbers are with Pawar.
This, Rajiv,
there's no point in hanging
is,
on.
Is at the core of politics that MLAs on the fence and MLAs in the Pawar camp, Ajit Pawar camp, will back the winning horse. If they think Sharad Pawar is winning, they are more likely to stay with Sharad Pawar than to want to support the BJP.
And the same is true of the independent MLAs also.
Rahulji, there is a big legal issue in this case. When he has given the letter to the Honorable Governor, so at that time he was the leader of the legislative party of the NCP. So whose whip will work? Whose instruction will work? You know, still NCP has not thrown out Ajit Pawarji from the party. You know, and I completely agree with Kopikar Madam, that she is right that it will be decided only at the floor that who is voting for whom. I am telling you,
Ajit Pawar can say, I am the leader,
MLA,
I am still in the NCP, I have said that I am supporting the BJP, so
who is anybody
to question me?
No, there is a past precedent, both in the case of Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Manmohan Singh, letters of support were given by party presidents, not CLP leaders. The House has still not been constituted. These MLAs have not taken their oaths, and therefore the CLP's position only comes into play once the House has met. In this case, that has not happened. We have past precedents and there are court rulings. In the Arunachal CM Tuki's case, the Supreme Court has ruled on that. So let's not forget, this is a very significant point. It doesn't depend on the whims and fancies of people, you know.
No, but that, Javed, is something the court will decide.
Certainly,
this is the argument that Mukul Rohtagi is making on behalf of Ajit Pawar and Devendra Fadnavis. Whether the court believes that or the court takes the opposite position is something that we will know only once the Supreme Court decides on this. What we also know is that there have been protests in Parliament. We have some pictures coming in. I hope to have them out for you in just a moment. Pictures of opposition leaders protesting outside the Gandhi statue, saying that democracy is being murdered. So they're taking this issue up in Parliament as well. What's happened post Maharashtra, post Haryana, Javed, is that the opposition has got a bit of a fillip. They were earlier dead and gone, and they thought that, you know, Modi hai to mumkin hai, Modi will win. These two states and the verdicts there have given them some life, they got some bounce in their feet now.
Rahul, every time when people say, you know, the opposition is out, that there is no stopping the government or the powers that be, I've seen it in 84, Rajiv Gandhi had a far bigger majority than Prime Minister Modi has at the moment. He had 400 plus MPs. And yet, because he Bofors happened, VP Singh came out of the. There are issues that act as catalysts which bring people together. Perhaps, I'm still underlying this in capital, perhaps this could be that kind of issue which will bring the opposition together and make them realize that these two are not invincible. That if you join hands,
Javed, the fact is that we saw something similar in Karnataka as well.
That's why I've underlined the word corrupt and incohesive.
That JDS Congress government was. So even if you would ordinarily imagine that adversity brings you together, it acts as a solidifier, it acts as a glue, but there is no guarantee about that. So now what you're seeing on your screen.